I have the honor tonight of giving the remarks for our honoree, Scott Carmilani. We have been very, very fortunate to have great honorees historically here at Answer the Call, and Scott's a special person. I have known Scott Carmilani for over 20 years. We grew up in the business together, he being the great underwriter at AIG, then to AWAC, and now Fairfax, and I being the broker trying to convince him to do things that he never wanted to do. And over that time period, we built a friendship, we built a trust, and today we share a relationship that I cherish very much. Scott grew up in New Jersey. He was a high school wrestler star. He also wrestled in college. And I can tell you, every issue he's tackled since then, he's been wrestling. He's a great father. His daughter, Brianna, is with him today. He believes in his people, he believes in his friends, and he believes in all of us in this room today. When I went to him and asked him to be the honoree, he didn't hesitate. He said, "How can I help?" Scott remembers 9/11. He was working downtown that fateful day. He knows what the first responders did for everybody in this room, for our families and for our friends. And he's taken a long view about New York City and what first responders have done to make this city great. He totally gets it. The greatest thing about Scott is he's had great success in business, he's had great success personally, but he's never changed. He's the most down-to-earth person I've ever met. He's straightforward, he's direct, you always know where you stand. So when he said yes, I know he wasn't going to retrade me, I know he was going to dedicate himself to it, and I knew we were going to have a very successful dinner. It is very, very difficult, as I mentioned earlier, to find people to take the time, make the effort, and support an event like this. We all have busy lives. And then yesterday happens, and it all becomes clear to all of us in this room why we're here. We live in a city that we're allowed to move around freely. We live in a city where all different types of groups of people are allowed to succeed. We live in a city where race, color, religion do not matter. When I travel to different parts of the world and I come back here, I'm not worried about the United States succeeding because New York City leads the way. Scott gets that. So he's happy to carry the mantle this evening. He's happy to financially support our cause, and he's happy to emotionally support it. I'm honored to invite him up to the stage to accept the award as this year's honoree for the New York Police and Fire Widows and Children's Benefit Fund. Scott, will you please come up?
Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you, Phil, for those kind words. For those of you who don't know Phil, or even for those who do, giving him a microphone in a room in an audience like this, you never really know what you're going to get or what you're in for, so I appreciate those kind words. Being an honoree in an event like this is more like realizing that you're the highest bidder in a silent auction. Yay, we win! Really? Wait a minute, what am I in for? What did I get here? I wasn't sure if I'd get a stack of PBA cards or a police escort to the airport. None of that, but hey, that's not what I signed up for. What we're really here for is to honor and support our police, fire, men and women. It's not often where you follow a rabbi or a priest, but I can tell you in life I've never followed either of them or both at the same time. I want to thank all of our first responders. Thank them all and for all they do for us. You are the backbone of this great city. You fuel yet control the energy here so that this city thrives. All while keeping the sanity amongst the chaos, and as stated earlier, we've had no shortage of chaos in recent events. all along the way, and of course, you're there to protect us, one and all. I especially want to thank all of you who are here tonight, the attendees. I know that the police and fire departments appreciate you coming out. Just look at that show of strength and force that was presented to us as we made the walk over from the Deutsche Bank lobby. As we entered the building tonight, what a show. What a show of force. Very, very impressive. As Phil said, this event and this organization provides such a meaningful benefit to so many families and children. It's more than 600 plus, I've learned. That is truly an amazing thing. And the fact that there are only 2 employees on staff, I've never been involved or supported any charity where virtually 100% of all the funds raised go right to the beneficiaries and fill the cause. Yeah, that is worth applauding. That board does all that work for free, and the 2 women who run it do an amazing job. And therefore, that's why I'm honored, but more humbled to be a part of this event and this cause. And I couldn't feel better about personally contributing to its success. Thanks to all of you for coming out tonight, for donating your time tonight, and for donating some of your money. Phil will try to get the rest of that out of you later, I'm sure. Thank you very much. Enjoy.